In this video, we will be discussing how to add pertinent billing information to your patient's electronic chart, including information such as legal representative, referring provider, insurance information, and referral authorization numbers. To begin, first you will need to search for your patient. To do this, click on the patient search icon under the main menu header on the main screen of TRAKnet. This will open the patient search window. You can search for a patient by a series of criteria available from the drop-down menu on this screen. We are going to search by patient last name. After entering the patient's information, click on the patient from the list, then click OK to open this patient's chart. We are going to begin by entering some basic information to our patient. To do this, we can click on the Demographics button next to the patient's name. This will open the patient editor window. The patient editor window will contain a variety of generic information about this patient, such as general demographic information, billing information, and a variety of patient preferences. We are going to focus on the billing portion for this video. To access the billing portion, simply scroll down until you reach the billing category. This section will contain information such as marital status, student status, and legal representative, among other items. To add information to one of these categories, simply click on the drop-down menu in that field and enter the necessary information, as we are demonstrating in this video. There are some instances, such as employer or legal representative, where you will need to search for other information in your database to tie to this patient's chart. To do this, click the box at the end of this field with the ellipsis in it, then search for the necessary information. If what you are looking for is not already in your database, click on the green plus sign to add it on the fly. There are also a variety of free type fields on this screen as well, such as the statement message, a field which will allow you to set a custom message that will print on only this patient's statements. To enter information into these fields, place your cursor in that field and then type in the necessary information. Finally, the last two categories, hold charges to and from, and the date to collections, will allow you to choose a date from a drop-down calendar view of when you would like these two fields to take effect. Setting the hold charges dates will prevent claims from being sent to this patient. Setting the date to collections will indicate that this patient is currently in collections. There is another category, marked Other, where several other billing-related items for this patient can be entered. Scroll down in the patient editor window to access this category. In this category, you will find information such as the referring provider, the primary physician, and the date last seen. You can enter this information into the patient's chart in a similar manner to those items which we just discussed. Once you have finished adding information to the patient's chart, click Save in the upper right-hand corner of this window to save and close this window. Now that we've added some basic billing demographic information to our patient, let's discuss the billing tab of the patient's chart, where information such as insurance and primary authorization number can be entered, and items such as the patient's ledger can be viewed. To access this information, click on the Billing tab at the top of the patient's chart. This screen will have several icons along the left-hand side. The first of these icons is insurance, where the patient's insurance information can be viewed and updated. Once on this window, click the green Add button to add an insurance to this patient's chart. Clicking Add will open the Add Insurance window. Once on this screen, click Select Insurance to search your entire list of insurances to find which would belong on this patient's chart. Select the insurance from the list and then click OK. After adding the insurance company, you will now need to enter important information such as subscriber number, group name, group number, copay, and the insured party's information. If the relationship to the insured party is self, the information will auto-populate. If it is anything other than self, you will choose this out of the Relationship drop-down menu, and then click Select Subscriber in the upper right-hand corner to choose which patient this information should pull from. For this training, we are going to keep this set to self. There are two additional tabs on the insurance window where information about this insurance can be set. The Claim Details tab will allow you to determine how any claim sent to this particular patient's insurance will send, be it electronic or paper. You will also set the auto-adjust settings. A general rule of thumb with these settings is that for primary insurances, you will want to set this to the default, that is, a claim output of electronic and an auto-adjust setting of true. For secondary insurances, however, you will want to set these settings to none and false. The final tab on the Add Patient Insurance window is a Comments tab, where any general comments about this patient's particular insurance can be set. After you have finished entering all information or making any changes, click Save in the upper right-hand corner of the screen to save this insurance. The final step of adding a patient's insurance information will be setting the sequence, that is, setting this to be either the primary, secondary, or tertiary insurance. To do so, click on the desired destinations drop-down menu and select the insurance record from this menu. Should you need to modify an insurance setting that has already been added, simply click on the insurance from the list and click the Modify button. After an insurance has been set up, there will be one additional tab that will appear. That is the Eligibility tab. If you are using the integrated eligibility system through TriZetto, you will be able to check patients' eligibility information from here. For more information on this, please reach out to our sales team. The next item on the Patient's Billing tab is the ledger. The patient ledger will show all encounters, charges, and payments for this particular patient, as well as any outstanding patient or insurance balances. The patient ledger provides several filtering options that will allow you to view the ledger as you see fit. These are located on the left-hand side of the ledger window. To change a setting, simply double-click on that setting or select True or False from the drop-down menu. There are also several options beneath these general ledger filters that will determine what types of information you see. For example, you are able to set a custom date range, whether or not you are seeing all items or just those for certain providers or locations, and if you would like to filter out any encounter that is or is not patient responsible. You can open a certain date of services invoice from the ledger as well by clicking on the desired date of service and either clicking the Modify button or double-clicking on that date. Here you are able to review that date of service, post any payments, or make any changes as needed. Using the icons listed along the top of the patient's ledger, you are also able to print, see a print preview, or take in a payment from the patient's ledger. At the bottom left-hand corner of the patient's ledger is a drop-down menu. You can set this to either patient or insurance to determine which outstanding balance you would like to see listed along the bottom of the screen. The next icon on the patient's billing tab is the statements icon. Here you can see a list of all past statements generated for this patient, as well as print a new one by clicking the green Add button. The next icon is the authorizations icon, where prior authorization numbers for this patient will be recorded. To add a new prior authorization number, click the green Add button. This will open a small pop-up window where the authorization number, the insurance company, the date range, and the number of approved visits can all be entered as demonstrated in this video. Once you have finished entering all information into this patient referral authorization record, click the OK button in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen to save this record. All prior authorization numbers for this patient will then be listed under the authorization screen. Beneath the statements icon is the remarks icon, where billing-specific patient comments, or remarks, can be added to the patient's chart. To add a remark, click the green Add button. This will open a pop-up window where you can free type any comments or remarks as you see fit. These will then link to any invoice for this patient, appearing as a small red alert. This concludes our video on adding billing information to the patient's chart. For more information and training materials, please visit our website at www.traknetpm.com.